Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. Now today I'll be doing a bit of a different video on this. This is the Acer laptop. Now I couldn't really give you a model number, but I've got the specs. Well, two specs in particular that we'll need to know. So that is, you can see there, the 840M GTX and the Intel i5 processor. Now this cost me about £250, and let's see how we do. So we started off with Dead Island. Now the resolution of this of the monitor, I can't remember exactly, but I'll stick it up. Maybe I think it's above 720p. We'll just have a look in a second. Yeah, 1366 by 768. So quite a nice looking panel. Obviously I can't record it directly off screen, so I had to set up the old camera. So this is running at high, at the highest resolution, and as you can see in the top left there, we are getting a solid 60 throughout. And you know, Dead Island is just one of those games I like to relax to, chop a few heads off, it would seem. But I love this game. If you watch my series, my channel, you can see my Let's Play video that I've only done one of so far. But this laptop, like I said, is very expensive. I bought it a couple years ago, and you know, it's done me quite well. I don't tend to play it a lot because I've got a high spec machine, but it's nice to have it on the go. I sort of look at it as a portable 360 sort of thing, with higher resolution in some games and higher frame rates. See, my gameplay isn't particularly great, but I do what I can. I'll be testing a few games in this video to see how we get on. And I'm dead. I died. Didn't do very well. But you can see the machine is handling this game with ease. It's not a problem at all. Admittedly, this game is a few years old now, but you know, it's one of my favorite games, so I like the machines I played on to play it well. That was a pretty sweet maneuver, if I do say so myself. So Dead Island, if you want to play Dead Island on a machine of the similar specs, then no problem. So here we go with another one of my favorite games. This is Shadow of Mordor. Not Shadow of War, not the newer one. But I love this game. I've played it to death. I actually had it on the Xbox 360 when it first came out, because I didn't have a PlayStation 4 when it came out, and the frame rate and everything was significantly worse than it is on this laptop. Now this game, I believe I'm running it at either 720p or the native resolution of this monitor, but it is at the lowest graphical settings. But because, you know, obviously you're playing it on the monitor, it really doesn't look that bad at all. And we're getting, you know, just below 40, just above 30, just about, you know, thereabouts. There we go, got steamrolled by a Caragol. But it runs, you know, this is perfectly playable, especially if you had played the Xbox 360 version. And it's just a fantastic game. It really is. I don't know how many hours I've sunk into this game, just finding different captains and killing them. And fantastic game, and very well optimized for the PC as well. Those cowgirls will not leave me alone. Still holding above 30. That's what I tend to have, like to have games at least right in that. I'm not really one for forcing a game, well, not forcing a game, but, you know, making a game run at 60 constantly, if I can. You know, I'm perfectly happy with 30 frames a second, because I do play quite a lot of console gaming, and obviously, you know, it's most of their games are at 30 unless they're specifically designed not to. You know, I don't think you need to have above 30 if it's not a first-person shooter. That's just my controversial opinion anyway. And I do apologize for the video quality, but I did the best I could with what I had. I did try to film a video similar to this, about this laptop, but I couldn't get any screen recording software to work. And when it did work, it dropped the frame significantly. So I tested out Dead Island with one screen recording software on this, and I think it dropped it down to like 25 frames a second, which wasn't an accurate representation of the laptop, so I thought that was quite unfair. So it's a bit unfortunate, but it's the best I could do. Just bump the camera there. My setup for the camera wasn't great either, so I apologize about that. And a classic here, Left 4 Dead 2. Now, I've played this game actually quite a lot on this laptop, and I know it runs very, very well. Obviously, quite an old game, but an absolute classic nonetheless. You know, so this is a first-person shooter, obviously, so 60 frames is what I like to see in a first-person shooter. Now, I was playing this, as you can see from the B-roll, I was playing this with a controller. Obviously, with a laptop, you just have a keypad. A mouse pad. So I don't like using that on games, because it's just, they're a bit rubbish, aren't they? You know, like I said, this game is very old, so it'll run, you know, about everything, but, you know, it's nice to have it portable, have it with you. If you're in a coffee shop or whatever, just boot up a game of Left 4 Dead 2. It's still a very fun game. I think it's best of its ilk, you know. I think Warhammer Vermintide is a close second, but Left 4 Dead is classic. So if you want to play it on something that isn't an Xbox 360, then, you know, this laptop for, you know, not a whole lot really when you think about it, will do just a trick. So I believe I'm running this on the highest settings at the highest resolution of the monitor, and it runs a treat. So it's one of my favorite games to play on this laptop. Know what I was trying to climb there? No idea. I don't even know why I swapped it out with the hunting rifle. I'm terrible with a sniper, so I went down to get my my shotgun again. And now, I think this is an underrated game, and I love it, just for the sheer gruesomeness, you'll see in a second. There we go. So this is Shadow Warrior. Again, an older game, but a game I like to play quite a lot. It's like Doom, but with samurai swords. How can you not enjoy that? And we're getting 50 to 60 frames a second in combat, which is fine to me. I forget what settings I have this on, but I'm sure you can adjust it accordingly if you wanted to get a solid 60. It's bloody gruesome. That was not a pun. Now I sort of lose my way a little bit here. Because it all looks very similar, so I'm like, I have no idea where I'm supposed to be going. I used to love to play the second one of this game as well, which came out a couple years ago. I don't know if this is going to be a third one at all, ever, but I certainly enjoyed it. Of course, a remake of the original Shadow Warrior, which I actually have as well. But I didn't want to show that running because that is a very old game and it runs absolutely fine. It's very Doom-like, but obviously it didn't pick up nearly as much traction as Doom did. Doom was the outstanding game of that genre, which is, I mean, it's fair enough. Doom games are absolutely fantastic. Look, there it is, a Shadow Warrior classic. A nice little Easter egg there. As you can see, I'm not very good with my directions of where to go. Then I spot the glowy thing, I'm like, oh, that's probably it, isn't it? So here's the bad guy. Let's get that. But if you ever get a chance to play Shadow Warrior, I'm sure it's cheap on Steam, so, you know, give that a shot. It's a very fun time. Gruesome, but fun. So I saved the most intense game for last, and one of the most popular games of all time, that is GTA 5. Now this is running on quite low settings, and I forget if it's 720 or low resolution, but I mean it still looks great, runs pretty well. Again, if you played this on the Xbox 360, you won't be disheartened by the visual or the resolution. So it's nice. I mean, this is if you don't have any game on a laptop to sink hours into, this is definitely one of them. You know, the best one. So. For £250 or thereabouts, you can get a i5 laptop with a GTX 860, 6 gigs of RAM, a terabyte hard drive, and you can play, you know, if it's slightly older games, then this machine will run it just fine. I wouldn't expect to play the Division 2 or, you know, the newer games out, but I think it's a fantastic bit of machinery. It's thick, mind you, but it's, you know, I think it's well worth the money if you are going off to college and you don't want to bring your big PC tower with you. I think this is a perfectly acceptable replacement that will get you through, and you can enjoy, you know, some of Steam's finest games. And obviously, you know, you can run games like Undertale and you know, easier games like that, but I'm very impressed with this. If you like this sort of content, please let me know. I'll might do some more on older hardware, and we'll see you later. Bye bye.